When is the best time for home improvements?
Cody, let's talk about that.
Hey, Colorado Springs neighbors. I'm Cody with Home Fix.
And I'm Chad Sahar with the Sahar Group with Engel & Volkers, Colorado Springs.
And we wanted to help you guys out to think about when is the best time to do improvements on your house. When's the best time for home improvements? Most of us end up putting those projects off till we go to sell our house.
Correct.
And we all say the same thing. We all say, man, we should have done this a long time ago. Our house doesn't even look the same. Maybe we should stay. Chad, you sell homes every single day. You help people buy and sell homes every single day. When is the best time to do these home improvement projects?
Such a great question, Cody. You know, a lot of thought and process goes into when is the best time. And a lot of times we encourage people to really considering that, doing that right away. What's your long-term goal? If it's considering saying, hey, we're not ready at the place in our lifespan to sell right now, but maybe we do want to make some home improvements. Those home improvements and really categorizing those can make an impactful difference on your property. So whether it's just little maintenance items or really being able to have Cody and their team come by and maybe considering tackling some of those kitchens and some of those bathrooms, which can have a big improvement over time with the value of your home.
Yeah, yeah. And being able to go to market with your home, and I'm sure you can attest to this, with a clean inspection report and having it be move-in ready.
Right.
Those two things are huge, and being able to sell for above asking price, whatever asking price is, or just being able to up your asking price because you know that you have those two things going for you.
That's right. You know, a lot of people, when you think about that, is you do have someone that's going to be doing an inspection on the property when they go to purchase your property. So a lot of times it's really addressing the roof, making sure Cody and their team, they come out, do a roof inspection. If you have not had one done in the last 5 years and you live in some of those areas where we've had some substantial hail damage, it's a great time to be proactive and make sure that you're able to get that inspected and to address any of those items. As well as just making sure that, hey, let's go through and make sure there's no plumbing situations or make sure there's caulking done around tile in the bathrooms and basically looking around the windows and making sure that the window frames are, you know, aren't cracking. And some of those little things can create a real peace of mind for a buyer, as Cody says, where people look at it as a move-in ready property where they're not going to have to put a whole lot of money once they go to move into
it. Yeah, it'll also help you avoid those little problems becoming much bigger problems. How would you recommend that homeowners kind of prioritize that list? Do they put the big things on top? Do they put the little things on top? How do you do that?
Right, great question. A lot of times it's just really establishing where your budget is. There's a lot of ways to tackle bigger projects without the bigger financial piece of that. Sometimes if it's can't completely update a whole kitchen, maybe it's doing things like updating faucets or updating light fixtures or putting cabinetry, you know, handles on the cabinet. So I would take it from the standpoint of let's, you know, establishing a budget where you get Cody and their team of estimators to come out, look at exactly some of the items that you want to address, and then being able to say, hey, where can we maximize our budget and where can we get the best bang for our buck per se?
Sure, sure. And knowing that the things that we really want, the kitchens and the master bathrooms, like the things that really make a house a home and really make it nice, those are the things that are the closers whenever you go to sell anyway. So
absolutely,
if we can make those investments there sooner rather than later, again, you can enjoy it in the short term, and then whenever you're ready to go to market with it, and maybe it's 5 or 10 years down the road, you're ready to do so, right? And another thing we know is finishing an unfinished basement does add that instant equity to your,
right,
your property. You know, you're adding square footage, you're adding bedrooms to your home. I mean, it is a great way to add value to your home really, really quickly.
So let me ask you a question, Cody. When's a traditional time that you guys see is the best year? What's the best time of year for you guys, especially when it comes to making a home improvement?
Yeah. So the remodeling industry kind of follows patterns, you know, like everything else does. It has seasons. So the seasons for remodeling, generally speaking, are early summer, whenever kids are out of school and you've got, you know, 6 to 8 weeks or whatever it is, you've got time in order to get that done. There's a big swell of remodels that start at the beginning of summer and then fall. So after school is back in session, leading up to the holidays, they want to get those projects done so that they can host or just be comfortable for Thanksgiving and Christmas, right? So what that means is that when people start those projects at those sort of traditional times, you kind of are joining the crowd in that, and that means that you maybe aren't able to start as soon, and that means you're not able to finish as soon. So if you want to avoid that and kind of, you know, our goal is to get in and out of your house as quickly as possible without sacrificing quality.
Right.
So if you want to avoid that, right now we're recording this video in late January, and this is a great time of year to do it. There's few people who are actually remodeling at this time of year. So starting that process at this time of year is a good time. And then late summer is another really good time. So late July, early August, kind of around that back to school time. And then the last one I'll say is December. Everything dies in December.
Right.
So maybe you're going out of town for the holidays or whatever it is. It's a great time to remodel and start that process then.
That's awesome. And you know, Cody, just to piggyback what you were sharing from the real estate side, a lot of times too, when we're talking to clients that are looking at selling, sometimes we can find out if they're taking a family vacation, where a lot of times when the market is, you know, it can be pretty substantially aggressive like it has been, you know, the last few years, where you know you're going to be out of town for a few months, just like you said, on vacation time frame, where you know that somebody can come in, get the project done, and it takes away the limitations of interfering with the family in itself. So,
totally.
Cody, such great information. If you guys have been looking at getting some work done on your property, looking at remodeling or thinking about doing kitchens and bathrooms, give Cody and their team a call. It doesn't hurt to get an estimator out there to really see. A lot of times we prohibit doing those things because we feel like it's astronomical, but you know, it doesn't, you know, a lot of times it can create substantial dividends to having somebody come out and take a look at it.
Yeah. So. Yeah. And likewise, guys, if you're thinking about listing your home, if you're thinking about moving, if you just want to know how much your home is worth, Chad's your guy. He always has operated with a lot of integrity. And I know that whenever me and my wife go to put our house on the market, he'll be our first phone call. He's your guy.
Awesome, Cody. Thank you, brother. Yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great new year.